So now we're moving on to some questions that are more trying to really tap into your understanding of the four rules that they gave you in the rules of equivalency. And the key thing here, I was kind of struggling as to how to explain this or how to get you thinking about this. And the way that it always works for me is these aren't immediately obvious to me either. They don't jump out. The solution's not necessarily super obvious. So what I end up doing is I always relate back to one key piece of information. And that key piece of information is that basically circles are kind of magical. A circle maximizes the area enclosed by a set perimeter. And similarly, it actually minimizes the perimeter for a set area. So it's two ways of really looking at the same thing. So whenever I'm trying to figure out these questions that are dealing with which one gives you the maximum or minimum based on your regular polygons and that kind of thing, I always relate it back to a circle. A circle is the most efficient shape. And when we start talking about three dimensions, a sphere is the most efficient shape. But for now, we're just in two dimensions. So the closer that a shape comes to resembling a circle, the closer it comes to being optimal, either giving you the maximum area or minimizing the perimeter. So let's see how that applies when we step into some of these questions. So question 10 says you've got three triangles, an equilateral, an isosceles, and a scalene triangle, and all have the same perimeter. And then they ask you which one has the greatest area. So what I did is I actually drew out four rectangles here, or triangles. This one is more or less equilateral. This one is an isosceles. This one's an isosceles, but a much more extreme steepness to it. And then I've got a scalene triangle. And they're fairly close to being scaled properly. The perimeter is more or less the same on all of them. And I drew them this way to hopefully help it be more obvious as to the rule about which one's going to give you the maximum area given a set perimeter. So with this first one, if you look at the equilateral triangle here, the area looks pretty large. But if you compare it then to this isosceles triangle that's very tall and skinny, it's fairly easy to see that that tall and skinny triangle, you could keep going, you could stretch it out, even make it even taller and make the base even smaller to the point where you had virtually nothing inside the enclosed space. And then if I asked you the question, which of these comes closest to resembling a circle? The answer is the equilateral triangle. Admittedly, it's not that close to being a circle, but it's a lot closer than this one, for example, which is really starting to look a lot more like just a plain line. And even the scalene triangle here, you know, you can see that as you keep getting steeper and steeper in the triangle, the space inside is going to get smaller and smaller. So if you think about it, the equilateral triangle is going to give you the maximum area if you're working with a set perimeter. Another thing to think of when you're trying to answer these types of questions is imagine that you had a string and you were playing with that string. The string was tied, so it was a continuous loop, and you were reforming that loop of string into different shapes. And then think about how it would appear as you manipulate it, which one, like I said, just keep in mind that the circle is the optimal space. And so as you get closer to being a circle, you're going to have the maximum, you'll be maximizing area given your set perimeter. So all of that to say, the question 10, the equilateral triangle gives you the maximum area given a set perimeter.